We came all the way from Hollywood to buy our cars from the number one dealer.
And I'm one of your number one fans. But where's Michael?
What are you doing on Michael?
I'm looking for him. I'm looking for him.
This was supposed to be Michael Jackson's month, the premiere of his most expensive video ever. But now he's been sabotaged by his big brother.
The television premiere of Michael Jackson's video Black or White from his long-awaited Dangerous album exploded in controversy over scenes of violence and sexual innuendo. The scenes were cut the next day, but was it a publicity stunt? The same question was raised when brother Jermaine released his new album, You Said, at the same time. But what he claimed shouldn't have come out was a single called Word to the Bad, which seemingly slams his famous sibling.
Radio stations are playing it every hour, back to back with Michael's new single, Black and White.
And according to a spokesperson for the station, Jermaine's song is getting a better response than Michael's.
I'm sure Michael would like to go to Jermaine.
Promise I'd play you the brand new Jermaine Jackson record, and here it is. Jermaine heats up the sibling rivalry with this early version of a song called Word to the Bad. Turned up at radio stations in Los Angeles and New York.
Listen to the lyrics. Everybody's talking about this one. It's called Word to the Bad. Who do you think he's talking about?
Once you were made, you changed your shape. Was the color wrong?
The lyrics, which clearly are an indictment of Michael Jackson's ego and alleged lightening of his skin, have been softened on the album that's in the stores.
Brother to Brother is changed to Lover to Lover, so fans would have no inkling of who the song's about. But thanks to the secret tape, now they do.
Jermaine just finally let it go and let it all out in this song, and maybe had second thoughts when he released the album, but the original thoughts are there.
On the tape, Jermaine criticizes Michael for his continuous trip to the plastic surgeon.
He runs the dead, been abducted, don't know who you are.
There's a lot of people who feel the same way about siblings. They just want to shake them by the shoulders and go, come on, come on, get real, get a grip. And it's mostly a song out of love.
Bitter Jermaine, second banana in the old Jackson 5. He criticizes Michael for everything, from lightening his skin to being plain weird.
Could not turn back, it's unknown fact.
Michael's new billion-dollar deal on the line, it could be his most costly embarrassment yet. And with brothers like Jermaine, who needs LaToya?
When Michael became very successful, Jermaine was very hurt by it, and he didn't like it.
He created one of the earliest family rifts in 1975 by staying behind at Motown Records when the group changed labels. Jermaine was married to Motown founder Berry Gordy's daughter.
Word to the Bad may be a top 10 hit in more ways than one.
Could the recording have been leaked as a publicity stunt, especially with the upcoming release of Michael's new album and short film, trumpeted by this David Lynch-produced promo?
I don't know if it's definitely a publicity stunt. It would hurt the family. They're in so much turmoil as it is now. It definitely is a message song, and that's the bottom line with it.
Throughout it all, the two most famous Jacksons, Michael and Janet, remained silent. But the rest of the family seemed determined to air its dirty laundry and prove true that old adage that success does not buy happiness.
Yet another famous family with a lot of unhappiness.
A highly critical song was never intended for release, but was mysteriously leaked to two radio stations last weekend. Jermaine Jackson is with us on the line now from Sherman Oaks, California. Jermaine, good morning.
Good morning, Brian.
First of all, how'd this record get out? Any ideas?
I have no idea.
Who'd have reason to leak the record, Jermaine? Who'd have something to gain from doing something like this?
I really don't know. I really don't know.
The song hadn't leaked when we talked with Jermaine, but he's resigned to competing with his younger brother.
In our family, there are so many albums coming out, and sometimes we run into each other, and I guess we all want it to be out at this time of year. We support each other. It's very important for us all to do well.
Let me run a popular theory by you. There are a lot of people who believe, hey, this is not coincidental, that this all comes about as Michael's song, Black and White, is also about to be released, and that as a result of all of this, what's going to happen is your record's going to sell more than it would have, and Michael's won't sell any less.
Brian, who's all saying that? It's not true. If this was a publicity stunt or whatever, I would have called my album Word to the... I would have done it upright. I would have called my album Word to the Bad. I would have stuck it out there, and I would have stood by... Yes, I wrote the song, and I wrote it from my heart. I have a single out there called You Said, You Said. That's the name of my album. There's no way that this was a publicity stunt. It leaked out, it's out there, and I got to deal with it.
Why'd you write it in the first place?
I wrote it in the first place, Brian, because I was angry during the time. Michael's my brother, but I was angry. We're creative people. I couldn't get to him, so I put it in a song. You know, my frustrations, I put it into words.
But we didn't sit down and say, well, we're going to write a song about Michael. We just wrote a song, and it just happens to be taken.
You were mad enough to write these lyrics, but you changed the lyrics before the song was actually released.
Yeah, because I felt that, I spoke to him, and then I said, Michael, I didn't do this song about you.
So you meant for him to hear this at some point. Hear about the song.
Jermaine, the words are, you changed your shade. Was your color wrong? Do you resent the manner in which your brother has changed his look so as to minimize his black features?
Reconstructed, been abducted, don't know who you are?
Yeah.
Did you feel that way? That he didn't know who he was?
Basically, I felt that he was missing something. He wasn't communicating. And what was very hurting to me was the fact that a bit of the communication thing wasn't where it was, and I wasn't getting to him as soon as I...
You mean he wasn't
to.
Returning your phone calls?
Well, is it just that he was working on something, and it's really, when you really get down to the bottom of it, it's really not him, it's the people around him.
The song is not about one or two lines. The overall message of the song is a healing process for myself, my relationship with my brother.
It's pretty much of the public sometimes who wants to create rivalry and this and that. But what we try to do is just do our best. And when we come together as a unit, that's when you really see that it's a family unit.
Were you ever jealous? So it was okay with you when your little brother
perfectly
went out
okay.
front?
Perfectly okay, yeah.
Jermaine, as I think you know, on this program last September, your sister LaToya said,
Jermaine is definitely jealous of him. I mean, it's very blatant that he's very jealous of Michael or anybody that succeeds in that matter in the family.
That's ridiculous. Who has not had success in my family? We were the Jackson Five. Every song Michael sung on, I sung on. We helped build what's going on right now. It's not about that. It's about family, Brian. That's the most important thing here.
How would you characterize your relationship with him, Jermaine, with Mike?
Well, we've spoken since all this has happened, and we're fine now.
Once the song came out, we talked and we spoke and everything, and I said, Michael, we have to talk because family is very, very important, and I love you. We started together, but I was very upset.
We have to make time, and like I say, I'm not blaming Michael for what has happened, his schedule, and this and that. He's a very successful person. But still, we're family, and that will always be there.